Maybe this is too loud, maybe I should. This is good? You hear me?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so welcome to the course in Introduction to Mathematics. I see that you are, most of you are here, I guess. You should be 40 people. And this is a bit too much for me. So today is just basically practicalities. I have to get your names and actually and your email addresses and so on. So I sent out an email, I think, on Saturday or Friday. Did you all get it?
No.
No, someone did not get it. So the people who didn't get it, the best would actually be if you just send me an email. And my email address is on the homepage, it's, which is this one. That's bioinfo.ac courses introduction to mathematics. This is, I think, how to look back here also. Someone said that the email, the page looks strange in Windows something with Internet Explorer. I tried to check it, and for me it looks okay. Not Internet Explorer doesn't really work, but if you use Chrome or Firefox, it should work. I think. If not, we'll try to fix it. So we try to keep all these men here, and as I think I said in the email, the idea is not that I'm going to stand here talking, except today. The idea is that all the lectures are all recorded on video, so they're just on YouTube. So if you take the first lecture here, even this one is, I think, actually recorded. So if you go here, you should end up here, and there should be a YouTube link there that shows me. And basically choose this slide. So this you should be able to watch anywhere.
So welcome to the course.
Wow. So welcome to the course, exactly. And here you also have my email address. So you are missing, send me an email and just set up site if I'm missing. I will do rule calls, make sure who is here anyway later. Because there is a web, just a Google group email list where I tried to send out information. I tried to use the Stockholm University one, but there was only 6 people on this one, so it didn't really work. And I managed to get the last email address on Friday night. I thought it was lost one, but I missed some reason, I missed some. And if you don't know each other, I think half of you are basically from the SciLab Lab and Master's program, and the other half are from Stockholm University in the Master's programs and individual courses. So it is a mix of students. But the idea, my assumption is that most of you are biochemistry, molecular biology, life science students. You are not very computer programming students.
Teacher students.
Yeah. So that my assumption normally in this course are mainly people who are not very computer science oriented. But the idea of this course is there are two things. One part is actually that you get familiar using computers. We don't mean computers by clicking on a web browser, but actually doing something, some programming, some using some tools, online tools and so on. So that would be the first, basically for all the labs the first week, almost will be that, and even a bit the next second week. And the second part is to teach you bioinformatics, and there we are going to teach you both how to use things, but also how the fundamental algorithms work. So they are a bit more, it's not really mathematics, but at least understanding how algorithms work. And also limitations, and also a number of practical projects. So the last lab is a secret sequence project. So you will get one sequence, protein sequence, and you're supposed to, in half a day, figure out as much as possible about the sequence. And you're going to write a short report on that. We also have one oral presentation that you will do at the end, so you will get assigned, I don't know, if we'll do it maybe in couples to not kill ourselves because we're many students. So we'll read one scientific paper and make a short 20-minute presentation on that. Probably we'll do 2 and 2. Okay, so any questions so far? No. Okay, so I will teach most, or I will not teach, you will see me on YouTube most videos, There are a few lectures given by other people that are Gunnar and his professor here in the department, so he will talk about memory problems. And then Ilya and Petros and Joanna are coming here from Kansas. We happen to have a collaboration with them, so they will give one lecture each. These are not available on YouTube in advance, but they will just be given as normal lectures. And I will try to get the slides and put them on the side of afterwards, but it's up to them what they want to do with it. Then we have a number of assistants. So John is one of them sitting here. And the other ones are Marco, Mirko, Karis, David, and that's it all. So they are the ones that are actually running all the assignments. So John and David are mainly running the computer, Python programming, and Mirko and Marco mainly the assignments in for the bioinformatics labs. So they're going to be there to help you. And the assignments are done in the computer room, which is just around the corner over here. But unfortunately, we have 30 computers there, but so we can't be there all at the same time. So I will have to divide into two groups, an A and B group. And it's not a problem if you change groups, but as we are 40 students, something like that, and only 30 computers, we can't all be the A group. So the ones that are assigned to the original group have at least priority to be there when it's their time. If there's space extra, you can go to the other one. So that shouldn't be a problem. And also, you can be about 10 free computers every time. So most people could manage. So you have to also manage that. Basically, the schedule is like this. We have a lecture here at 1 o'clock, not most days. Or at least, I would want more discussion. I basically will expect you to have watched the lecture before and read some material and post some questions on the webpage, and then we will discuss. Yes?
Could you show us how to pass questions on
the web? I can try that. So that's, I think it should be, this one doesn't have any enable that. But, so basically you have just the equal replies. It should be like, you should be able to just type here, this is a question. I hope this works, because this is the first, we changed system last year. So here, there's one response.
Do you have to ask a question? For example, if I do not want to answer something?
Well, let's put it this way. Nothing is mandatory except doing the labs and assignments. But if there are no questions, well, there's no reason for me to be here. So if there are no questions, we will have a very, very short discussion. So it's up to you. It's not a requirement. I'm not going to check who asks questions. But this is really the way to have a discussion. I don't think there's any real meaning for me to give the same lecture as you can watch on YouTube another time. So that's really, if there's something that's unclear, if everything is perfectly clear, you know everything, fine. But really, this is your chance. It's not the demand, but I think it's a good idea. Because if there's something that's not clear, I know most students start reading like 24 hours before the exam, but that's not the best strategy. So I try to ask you not to do it. I know it will be very hard, but it's you will have a long night last night if you haven't done it before. So that's I'll be here and we'll discuss, and hopefully some people will ask some interesting questions. Okay? Do you think it sounds like a good plan? We haven't tried it before. I know other people have tried it. So this is the first time I do it. So I think it could be good. Because I think it's really a bit not very efficient that I stand there, talk the same thing, give the same lecture every year. And actually, in most of the places, if I look at my lectures from the last 2 years, 2014, 2016, because it must be changed the schedule. So, these lectures are not, and the sound quality is not extremely good, because I used just this small camera here and not the microphone. So it might be better to watch the videos that are up here on top. And I also try to divide these videos into small parts, so they are about 10 minutes each, so you don't have to watch these. And for many of these lectures, there are actually much better people than me to present the same thing on the web. So I try to sometimes link to them to do it, because they are much more pedagogic than I am. So that's, but they cover more or less the same topic.
Okay.
And the same thing with reading material. Basically, the reading material is very much based on a few articles and made very much on Wikipedia articles. So yeah, that this is a book. If you want to read it, it's okay, but it's a bit out of date. So that's why I don't want to really force people to buy the book. So I would use only a small part of it. So basically, you should be able to manage the course by just reading whatever is on the web and looking and watching lectures. So back to introduction lecture. Just one small trick here. If you see this page, and if you're on a mobile phone or something like that, if you click this corner here, the menu disappears. Because on a mobile phone, it gets very crowded. The menu takes the whole space. Don't click on this one up here, because then actually the whole page disappears, I think. So then you have to go back there again. But on the computer, it looks quite nice, I guess. But on the phone, it's much better if you hide the menus. Okay, so we have teachers, guest lectures, assistants. I don't know if I would use on Twitter, but in that case, I leave it to hashtag. I get so many Twitter tweets that I never read. Homepage, you all defined the way here, so you know where we are. And the computer room is called A244. This is schedule, the map here. And this is just the calendar, and you should be able to import it into your Roma calendar if you want to. So that basically just shows you what to do every day. So if you look at that. So today we have this lecture here, and then we have a lab for group A. Tomorrow we have a lab for group B, and then the first lab for group A, etc. So the first lecture that I will have here is on Wednesday at 1 o'clock. Actually, there are two introductions. There's both the one called Genes, Genomes, and Bioinformatics, which is like an introduction to the whole topic. And the other lecture is called Biological Databases. So that's a survey of what databases, what resources we use in bioinformatics. So I think it should be enough to have 2 hours to discuss both of them, because they are quite short. So you can go here, and I guess if you just click here, you can do add to your calendar, you get a link to it, you can add it to your phone calendar if you want to. Otherwise, you have to go to the home page, you can see it. Okay. So let's see if I have anything else I want to say. Introduction. Yes. Go ahead.
Sorry, is there okay you can go back to your website? I've got a question.
Yes, a second. I'll just find my slides. There it is. Okay. No, yes.
Would you mind going to like the second lecture, like the gene and genome?
Yes.
Semantics? You know how we got the mandatory readings, and then below that you got the videos and an introduction and molecular of life. Are those videos of like
mandatory
to the mandatory reading?
This is basically my lecture. I would say the videos are mandatory. I mean, only content of them. But I think that most of the information should be in the mandatory reading. Yeah. But I cannot guarantee that every single point is there. So I would say that the information in this, these are more or less mandatory. So that's. It's probably better for the exam to actually watch the videos than to read the material, because that's my view of how to present some things. But they are complementary, so they both things should really be done. And there are, so you see here, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 lectures, and I think it's 45-50 minutes in total. So it's notable. If you go to this lecture from this year, they are about 2 hours. And the lectures, when I do it without any questions, it gets much shorter. So it's normally about 1 hour to watch. So, yes, this is just the slides that you can see here. And so today, you will not have to make an account, because I've changed that. After the lecture today, you will, I will show you the computer OS, and the A group will start with the first lap. And well, the lap starts at 2 o'clock because the assistants have lunch at the moment. And I also think if you have questions, well, it's actually quite. I will try to reply to questions. You can, you're welcome to send me emails, that's the easiest way for me to reply. I make a call and whatever you want, but email is my preferred way of communication. And I think that I will try to reply on questions regarding the content of the course or answers or things unclear. I will try to reply to everybody in the whole group, because that's somehow fair and everybody gets the same information. I'm not if you ask, can I do this? Can I be late on Friday? I'm sick, can I come? Of course not, but if you send this question here is unclear, can I expect it better? I'll try to send it to everybody, yes. So all get the same information. And of course, I might be sick or something like that, and I have to change the schedule, but I'll use the email list to send out that information, or I will. Hopefully it won't happen. Yes, so this is basically just what I wanted to tell you. So, before the lecture, look at the videos, try to understand them. Sometimes you might think it's better to look at the old videos, but the old videos are in general longer and should have slightly worse sound quality. And I post questions in the commentary field. So, if there's something that you want to, on the reply field, if you want to, something that's unclear, go to that. And then we will use this lecture time to discuss. We will solve these questions, but anything that you have that you ask during the time, just raise your hand and ask it. And as I said, if there's no questions, there's no reason to have a lecture. So then we will have a good time. And I also try to record, so I'm recording this right now. I want to record your face, it's only my face. And but I also, if someone is sick and have or something missed it, they can I try to put it up. It can be useful for other people. And as I said, we have mandatory reading and extra reading. So they're basically, I try to use if you're mandatory, if you do that, you pass the course. If you want to have a top grade, you probably should read the extra reading also. And try to read before. It's actually much easier if you have, if you prepare for lecture for everybody. So, as I said, I'm dividing into two groups. I try to stick to group as much as possible, but I think you will have about 10 computers extra every time, so you can change. And you're not... Well, it's probably easier if you try to use the same computer every time. But I don't think it's absolutely necessary. But because your home catalog will be anyway on a central folder, but there are some local files you might want to save, and they're going to be only the local computer. And if you're, the assignments are also made that you're going to basically write a small document, page is black, I mean, it can be, something will be half a page, it's not very long. And you're going to send it in to John here or to one of the assistants. And the important thing I think, for me, at least for some students who have studied desktop university before, is that we're going to check every assignment for plagiarism. Basically, you cannot just take material and copy from the web. And this is done automatically, so it's a requirement that we have to do. And it actually just checks between you. So the first one might be something else, but if someone else has the same answer, the system checks that. So try to use your own words in your own way of writing when you answer the assignments. This is actually something that even my daughter is 12, in her school they do it, so that's really getting important, and it's getting almost as some things are difficult to formulate in too many different ways. So we are going to be if you write that bioinformatics is important or bioinformatics is used for studying sequences, I mean you can't write it in 500 different ways. So, but so that's okay. So that's what basically you're going to write a report in the Python programming. It's going to be a small Python program or one file you can send. And then the other one is going to be one Word or PDF document, text document that you can send in. So, the labs are the programming labs, the Python Unix, and the bioinformatics labs. And most of the labs in the beginning are Python Unix. So, So if you go back to the schedule, you can see here that you see that we have introduction, Unix, Python, and then you have one lab which is not Pragmatics here, and then another Python lab, and another Python lab Friday, and Monday is Python, and then it starts on a Siemens lab, and then it's a Python lab next week. And the final, so basically all the computer programming labs are the first 2 weeks. And that's because they are actually useful to know before some of the later assignments also. And also then we have time to go through the theoretical material for that during the course, before you have it. So there's a link here if you want to know more about plagiarism. And we try to basically say that we want to have assignments submitted within 3 days from the day you do it. And ideally it should be submitted directly, and I think you said something that you should try not to have more than 2 returns. So I think they say okay, or they say you have to fix this and this and this, and you get it back. But we try to be as quick as we can. But it always takes, even the system for checking the attachments takes about a day, so you won't be able to get it okay in 5 minutes, because even the assistant will see the email before about 1 day, I think. And then I have this as a paper presentation. You will do this, you will be given a scientific paper, not until next week. And you should have to make a short presentation. So we will divide into two groups there, because we have too long day otherwise. So we will have half the group in the morning, the group A in the morning, group B in the afternoon. And you will make presentations and short presentations. And I think we'll do it pairwise, otherwise it will be too long. And of course, this is actually one of the things that's mandatory. You can listen to the presentation by others. You should be there and learn about the others. And of course, also there are actually questions that are in these papers that might occur on exams. It's a good thing to learn from these papers. Of course, it always happens that someone is sick or something like that, so it was mandatory not to be there. So if you're not there, you have to write in a written report instead. So that's the last Monday in the course, and the exam is on Wednesday. So people always ask how you do to pass the course, and basically you have to do these three things. You have to pass all the labs, you have to pass the exam, and you have to make this presentation. Like in most other courses. And this year we'll do 10% of the grade will be on the programming, and 10% of the backmanage lab, and 8% of the written exam. And you need to have 50% in total to pass the course. That's the standard Stock University rules. And you need to pass, but you need to pass all the labs, but you could in theory have a bit less than the exam if you have 100% on the labs. So the card, to get in a computer room, you will need a card. You will need to have one of these small plastic cards. I guess some of you might already have it because you're taking courses here at Department 4. So these cards. But they should be ready today or in an hour or something like that. So you should go to the secretaries at the floor 4 here out of the biochemistry and biophysics. And the one who's doing that is Elisabeth, I think. You basically have to show your ID and tell them the things for us. They should be ready. You get a computer account today. It will be just a computer account called Student 1, Student 2, etc. And you will get a horrible long password that you cannot change. I think it's only 9 letters and numbers, but it's so you get on the paper notes, and you probably will have to keep the paper notes, otherwise you forget about it. But that was the only way to make it easy to get to work. Yes, and the computer room is the same floor as this one. I think there's one lecturer who's going to be in another room. We're not going to schedule this in 2 weeks on that, because this room was booked. Otherwise, we can have all the lectures here. And the computer room is always going to be in the same place. So the next thing I actually should do is actually try to... Maybe we shouldn't do this any longer. To see who is here. Here's a separate display. So if I sit down here for a second, I'll try to. I'm probably not very good at pronouncing all the names, but I will just try to go through the people here. So the first one I can pronounce is Rickard Anderberg. Is there Rickard Anderberg here? No. The second one is then Alireza Azimi. Or something like that? No? Okay. The third one is Lorenz Bafa. That's you? You're here? Okay, good. And then is Axel Bergenstråle. Yeah. And Radoslav Gora. No. Nathalie Marie Henriksen. Yeah. Mette Indere. Miriam Jamil, Sara Kosselina, yes. Sylvia Kron, ja. Ramakant Mishra, yes. Agnes Mova, ja. Iona Murinidi. Babu Ravella Ayaya. Babu Ravella. No. Uska Rosnik. Yes. Royda Sahi. Björn Schmidt. Ali Tabish. Vasiliki Verschut. Something similar. Maria Isabel Aranda Guyen. Javier Arroya Gomez. Monica Chaloni. Manuel Esther. Rerant Gupta. Also knows I like that people. Vasileios Evripidis Kriokidis. The Greek are two long names. Tianin Ha. Are you from the name? No. I have a daughter from the name. Yes. Javier Ladinos, Rino Dawson, Vai Lee Ka.
That's me, but I'm thinking it's
not Lee, I can't pronounce at least.
That's my surname.
Yeah, that's one third of the people in Korea. They're the Lee in the park. Elinor Löfverli. Tanja Normark. Andrea Rosa. Carolina Sabatieto Brevanares. Spelar till båda för någon ens. Siddharth Tovar. Dimitri Alvin Virjo Verdojo. Det var från Berber utan allt. Leonie von Berlin. Wang Shuekin. Från egen vårt utan allt. Serien Ösken. Så det är två sidan där most people missing. Revant och Serien. Är det något de är coming? Or? They probably will. Yeah. So I put the question mark on this. And I guess there are some people at least. I have about five more names here that there was in one list but not in the last one. Ali Mustafa Tabish. No. Dharmesh Sabharwal. Stefan Milošević. Kimi Asobi, Nathalie Ilar, for those who have support. Okay, so we have a new people missing. I guess let's also do that at the end, before, so you don't have to stay here too long. Everybody, just the people missing, the people with emails missing, just come down and give me the information. And I think I have instructions what to do. So if you are students, not on these, should be added below with ID number, name, and email addresses. State on the comments that PC students not on this has to be. So you have to somehow go to anton.se or something to apply.
Yeah, that was the problem.
We already did that.
We are biochemistry master students, and we were told to apply in December when it's already too late. So then we were placed on the reserve list.
Okay, no problem. This is always the case. As I said, I got one list in December, and I got another list now. There was about 50% overlap between them, and there was, so I don't know if the system doesn't work very well, but that's we'll have to take care of it somehow. But I'm sure it's not a problem. Is that it's.
No, we talked to the guys in the department, and they say that there is no problem.
This is unfortunately it's not the department, it's not me who and the system, it has to be done by the people in Churl, and it's the same thing every year. And it's not that this year we have more students, so that's, so how many are we? We are 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, yeah, not really 40, so that's really hard. And I actually made a list. So can I get everyone guess for your name? So I'm going to show you personal numbers. I don't think to hide that. So if people are put an X on the people over here. So if someone finds the same name here missing from this list, let me know. And then you see if you're group A or B. So try to remember that.
Sorry, what should we do if you are missing?
Should we send an email? Let's come and talk to it down here, and I'll add you and put in the. And then I think you have to go to talk to the people in the show.
Okay, because I made a late application. Yeah. I'm not a master's student.
Yeah. We try to figure it out, and I'm going to send this to them, and probably, just start it, and I'm sure, if there's a problem, they will tell you later or something, but I cannot formally admit you, because they have to do it, so, but I don't think it's a problem, it's just, I need your personal number, your email address, and things like that, and then I assign it to A or B. So if someone sees his or her name with the other X and it's here, just tell me now. And then you see your A and B's here. So basically, try to remember it. So the first half is actually the Stock University students, the second half is on the Scilab Lab Master students. So, what was your name? Yeah. At the internet. I think I. I saw you somewhere here. There, you're here also. X on you. And your name is? What? Ali Rasa. There we are. So you're in group B. What? You are in B. I put. Up. No. Yeah, you're in A. So try to remember your A's and B's. It's not extremely important, but it's not that we don't fit all at the same time. And it's also. It's also easy to get more than the same numbers, because you're going to have to get more help. just switch. What's your name?
Yeah, for both of us, sorry. Number 33
and Smith 25. And you want to be B instead? But my brother's listen, talk to somebody else and change this. I'll start changing everybody here now. Okay, I speak for some of the people who are not. You're B and you're 25. And you want to be B also. Okay.
But that's okay because we can be
in A. Yeah, put your A. Yeah, that's easy.
Can I change to A?
And your name was?
Oh, I can swap my part.
Let's do that. Everyone doesn't have to hear everyone. Just everyone wants to do some changes. Come here and talk to me directly now after we finish. We're basically done. I thought of asking them questions, and except this one to one thing. That's easy to do one by one. Yes.
Is B always in the morning, or is it just the first week?
No, B is always in the morning. I've checked.
B is. I think most likely it's like that. Yeah. A is normally one, B is off, but maybe that's not fair. I should switch it around to make things complicated. I was less easy to write A first and B later. Yes, the computer system has nothing to do with that. Yes.
We'll get the
passerian card. Yeah, for people not on the list will probably maybe better ask a bit later because
they haven't. Yeah,
and someone opened the door. Also, remember the computer room. There's one important thing: is that it's an alarm, so make sure you close the door. It doesn't close it a bit badly, so make sure. Otherwise, it start beeping, and you can't work, and you become a guardian. It's a bit painful. And also, don't use the turn to open the door. Use this exit button. And also, there's a projector in there that you shouldn't touch either, because it's also an alarm. So if you touch that, even though they're putting in cable, it starts beeping. So that's we try to turn off the alarm for the projector, but that's we'll see how much time that takes. I'm trying to fix that things also, but it certainly will take some months. So another question here I had was actually when I decided that my master students will all take the project course later. But how many others have applied for that course or have plans to take it? After this, the department have two different courses. One is called membrane protein something, and one is called project in molecular life science. So the side after that, master students will take the project. I think the biophysics can choose. I think the biochemistry students think the membrane courses are membrane. So if you take membrane, I ask making sure you don't have too many students in this course. If you plan to take the project course, we just let me know sometime. I'm not a sign up for most, but other people. Yes, so we make sure. So I know how many people apply for it. Because you see, there's no communication between the systems there. It's because we use the same computer room, so we would only have, it's not going to be more than 30 people. Or maybe I can fix it somehow. But. Okay, so let's finish this and do the people.